Good evening.
Not on. Okay.
Good evening. Don't the graduates look great? Graduates, please be seated. Welcome to the commencement exercises for David H. Ponitz Career Technology Center. I am Lolita Christian, Assistant Principal. Before we begin this joyous ceremony, please remember to turn off your cell phones. Please be courteous to those around you by refraining from talking during the ceremony. We encourage you to express pride and enthusiasm by applauding and sharing. Please keep in mind that everyone wants to hear their child's name. At the conclusion of the ceremony, please remain in your seats while the platform party and graduates exit the stadium. You will be able to pick up your graduate from the visitor side and take pictures. No one will be allowed to cross the field. Thank you for your attention, and please sit back and enjoy the commencement exercise from David H. Ponitz Career Technology Center. Thank you again. And now I would like to welcome to our stage senior student Lauren Smith.
Good evening. My name is Lauren Smith. It is my pleasure to welcome Dr. Lolly, the superintendent, and her cabinet members, Mr. Ponitz, the Ponitz administration, Ms. Clark, Ms. Christian, Ms. Fiola, all the Ponitz staff in attendance, parents, guardians, close friends, and the Ponitz David H. Ponitz Career Technology Center Class of 2021 graduates. I extend my warmest congratulations to all of those receiving diplomas today and acknowledge all the support that has helped us along the way. We send you a huge thank you. Thank you for all the encouragement you have offered and in the many cases, the sacrifices you have made throughout our time in school and especially throughout this pandemic. Class of 2021, would you please take a moment and give a huge round of applause to acknowledge all of those who have supported you near and far, including your own classmates and the faculty. Graduates, we are here today to participate in praising our achievements of a four-year journey at David H. Ponitz Career Technology Center. The challenge has been real, but congratulations. You have just personalized your pathway to express who you are and what is meaningful to you, to prepare yourself for a future that is meaningful to you, to celebrate your commencement as your journey begins to become a productive citizen. I leave you with this quote by Susan Collins. Success is completion. Success is being able to complete what we set out to do each individual action. Each specific step, each desired experience, whether a big or very small errand. Congratulations, graduates. We are here today to participate in this ceremony that is a culmination of 16 years of schooling. Please welcome the valedictorian of 2021, Ilkhan Lufiev.
Oh, okay. I want to begin this by saying how happy I am that so many of my friends and classmates have made it to this point. We all had different struggles we had to face throughout the past 4 years. While some classmates shared their struggles with others, some faced those, some fought alone. Those hurdles didn't stop us. Rather, they helped us build ourselves up and taught us the meaning of perseverance. We all have achieved many goals and accomplishments that were a product of hard work and determination that cannot go unnoticed. I've had many ups and downs throughout high school as well, but with the collective help from my teachers, family, and friends, I was able to reach for the unimaginable. High school wasn't all trials and tribulations, however. I've made countless wonderful memories with my friends and classmates that have made the hard times easier to handle. Whether it was just talking about video games and anime at lunch, working on group projects, or having competitions in engineering, there was rarely a dull moment throughout the school year. Some of the best moments of high school were just hanging out with my friends in class and joking about random things from class to class. COVID, however, has made the latter half of high school odd, for lack of a better word. But things have been getting better. What I believe got undervalued during that time, as well as before the pandemic, is the support from all the teachers and staff. There was never a point throughout high school where I felt like my teachers weren't doing anything they could to help me achieve my goals. My teachers even helped me with stuff outside of school, such as Mr. Foster giving me notes for a class I was struggling with at Sinclair, or Ms. Meyer helping me proofread my essays for scholarship. With the help of Ms. Richardson, I got certified in Microsoft Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and Excel, and also learned about financial stability and how to buy things such like a house and a car. My pathway teacher, Mr. Kaiser, gave us the opportunity to earn a certification that could get us a job in the engineering field. These are only a handful of the hundreds, if not thousands of times, all of my teachers helped me over the course of my 4 years at Ponitz. So I once again want to say thank you for everything that you guys have done for me and my classmates. For the graduates of the class of 2021, I will say, don't let this be an end, but rather a new beginning. Remember the lessons we have learned throughout the 4 years of high school. Hard times eventually end. Turning to friends, family, and your mentors will help you through the hard times to lighten your burden. You are resilient. You are capable of achieving any goal you set through hard work and determination. A quote that I want to leave with you from one of my favorite shows that has helped me throughout high school is, "So I was not born with a whole lot of natural talent, but I work hard and I never give up. That is my gift." To end it off, I would also like to thank all the wonderful parents and guardians that helped us all achieve this milestone in our lives, as well as introduce my classmate, Jamia Thompson.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Jamia Thompson. I'd like to start off by sharing a quote from Cory Booker. Real courage is holding on to a still voice in your head that says, "I must keep going." It's that voice that says nothing is a failure if it is not final. That voice that says to you, "Get out of bed, keep going, I will not quit." It is that voice that has gotten us to this moment. Graduating from David H. Ponitz Career Technology Center, where you have the options of a career after high school, joining the military, or going to college. Our goals have no limits. We are now entering the world as responsible citizens in our communities. We all worked hard to get to this day, and our work did not go unnoticed. A high school diploma is a wonderful tool in this world, one that opens many doors of opportunity for anyone who have one. But graduation is not an end goal in itself, instead a part of the larger journey of life. Wherever your future takes you, let it take you somewhere. Life is a journey, and all accomplishments we achieve during its course should be taken as starting points for further achievements. There's pressure to find words to put the final year in context for your fellow graduates, to craft a message that will resonate, reassure, maybe even inspire as life after high school looms. That's difficult enough in the normal year. But this year, when school often didn't feel like school at all, when classmates and teachers were mostly thumbnail images on a flickering screen, when faces and emotions were masked in the country shrouded in death, discord, disease, death, and discord, finding the words to make sense of it all is all the more challenging. Despite all those challenges that we have faced as a nation, as a state, as a city, and as a school, we not only survived, but thrived. And here today, we celebrate the accomplishments of the last decade of schooling that have culminated into this momentous occasion. Class of 2021, be encouraged that the best is yet to come. Congratulations, we did it. Please welcome my fellow classmate, Centurion Campbell.
Well, we did it. Come get another round of applause. We all accomplished one of the major early milestones of our lives, high school graduation. This is a major step in the journey of our lives, one that should be recognized for its immense significance. We all worked hard to get to this day, and it did not go to waste. Oops. Graduating with a high school diploma is a wonderful tool in this world that will open many doors of opportunity for those going to the next level. With that being said, I would like to give thanks to all my opponents, teachers, and staff for all the points taken off for missing work and grammar checks and staying after the school when we need them. You all have not only gotten us ready for the road ahead, but you have put us on the right one. So before I go, I'm going to leave you all with an analogy that I love about the lion and the gazelle. Every day in Africa, a lion wakes up and a gazelle wakes up. It doesn't make a difference if you're a gazelle or a lion when the sun comes up. If you're a gazelle, you wake up with this notion that if I'm going to survive, I must outrun the lion or the slowest gazelle. Every day you wake up, there's going to be something you're going to have to outrun. For some of you, it may be friends holding you back, or it may be the inability to finish. But when you wake up, you're going to have to outrun something to survive. But the weird thing is, the lion is considered one of the most ferocious animals in the jungle. When the sun comes up in Africa, the lion has something to do as well. Even though the lion is great, the gazelle is not just going to let him come and eat him up. He's going to chase that gazelle down, and that gazelle is going to run for his life, but he's going to kill that gazelle. And the message that I'm trying to get you all to understand is, it doesn't make a difference if you're a lion or a gazelle. You still have to work, you still can improve, and you can still get better at anything that you do. As long as you're alive, you still have room for growth. So don't stop running. That's it. I would like to introduce you all to our wonderful principal, Miss Clark. She's worked so hard for us this year, and we appreciate her a lot.
Thank you, everyone. To the parents, families, and students of the class of 2021, you've crossed the finish line for now. There are other goals and dreams to strive for and support each other in achieving. I know the class of 2021 has major success in their future. They've survived, thrived, and adapted in this ever-changing year. It has been my honor to serve as your principal. You've made me proud through your success and your challenges. It is now my honor and privilege to say, Superintendent Lolly, I do hereby certify that the students here today have met or exceeded the requirements set forth by the Ohio Department of Education and the Dayton Public Schools. Each student has earned a minimum of 20.5 Carnegie units in the required courses. Dr. Lolly, it is with great pleasure that I present to you for your acceptance the David H. Ponitz Career Technology Center Class of 2021.
Good evening, everyone. I'm so happy to be here today. This has been an uncertain and challenging year, but we made it through. One thing is certain, these young people we celebrate tonight have shown the resilience, the grit, the determination, and the effort through each and every challenge to arrive here today. They are headed for success. Congratulations. As superintendent of the Dayton City Schools and by the powers entrusted to me by the Ohio Department of Education and the Dayton Board of Education, I do by here accept these candidates for graduation and release their diplomas to be presented at this ceremony. Board Member Wick Gagne, it is my honor to present to you the David H. Ponitz Career Technology Center Class of 2021. Congratulations.
Hello, all administrators, parents, and graduates. On behalf of the Dayton Board of Education, I'd like to extend my sincere congratulations to the David H. Ponitz Career Technology Center Class of 2021. Yay! This school year has not been like any other year before. You've adapted your lives to so many changes in a short amount of time, from logging in at home to attend school, to wearing a mask throughout the school day, to keeping your distance from your peers and teachers, and even playing sports with only a few family members in the stands to cheer you on. The year has certainly been difficult for you and your family. Despite the difficulties, there have been many triumphs. This year, as COVID protocols changed endlessly, you proved that you could adapt to any situation and make the most of it and still succeed. As the pandemic worsened and left us with more questions than answers about the future, you still showed up each day and put in the work to ensure your future would be bright no matter what. As the world began to open back up, you returned to in-person classes and finished out the year strong, despite the changes it brought to your life yet again. You kept going on, despite all of these challenges and changes that no one before you had ever experienced. There was no one to offer you advice because no one had ever been in your position. Throughout everything, you proved that you are determined, self-motivated, creative, and capable of solving any problem that comes your way. You are truly resilient, which is a skill that simply cannot be taught. Be proud of that and everything you've accomplished this year. I would like to take a moment to share a few highlights of the Ponitz class of 2021 with you. Students earned $1.1 million in scholarships. Students earned 257 college credits. 47 students earned career credentials. And 23 students passed the ACT Work Keys assessment, which measures career and workforce readiness. Now, on behalf of the Dayton Board of Education, I accept these students commended to me by the superintendent, and they shall be hereforth deemed graduates of Dayton Public Schools, and they shall be hereforth bestowed with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities afforded to graduates of this school system. I wish you success and everything in your future has in store for you. As you move to the next chapter of your life, please remember to carry with you the skills and knowledge you took from your time as a DPS. Please remember also that your Dayton Public School family will always be here to support you. Now, parents, families, guardians, teachers, staff, please join me in congratulating the Ponitz class of 2021.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Joanne Visca. I am one of the media arts teachers here at Ponitz Career Technology Center, and it's my privilege and pleasure to introduce, one by one, the class of 2021. Ilkan Medorovich Lutfiev. Christopher Luane Mays. Perlene Samuel. Lauren Elizabeth Emery Smith. Alea Janae Siobhan Young. Tantorian Keyshawn Campbell. Emarié Dior Combs. Adriana Reese. Diane Travelle Adams. Danye Trevez Adams. Serenity Janice Harris. Kenyatta Tanae Brooks. Tiasia Yvonne Walker. Jordan Legetta Chapman. Markayla Louise Brooks. Angel Corinne Davis. Natalia Valentina Escuntar Chamorro. Zawadi Binti Seiko. Martea Riche Person. Diogene Lajela Denise Snowden. Vache Latrice White. Derenice Danae Spearman.
Can you flip her name over? Hers is on that.
Mishana Jernay Williams. Jamaria Diamond Nicole Chancellor. Heaven Devon Allen. Gabrielle Marjorie Brooks. Amari Lawanye White. Naya Lachelle Birdsong. Adam Christopher Washington Jr. Carlisha Denise Cooks. Ronnie Tion Price.
Samira Maison.
Samira Maison Villanueva. Shania Natrice Israel. Jocelyn Kamikaze. Haley Gwendolyn Nicole Perdue. Michaela Marie Oakes. Suelen Cole Hall. Jayshawn Devontae Hart. Vasan Sakai Ward. Jelani Lavelle Davidson. Brandon Lamar Twitty. Zyria Waiki Wright. Clarice Shakuru. Method Baraka Nigoshima. Frolic Irakiza. Tierra Jaquay Brown. Janaya Cheyenne Uloho. Amaya Denise Jordan Hampton. Zaria Yasmin Love Johnson. Jarrett Allen Brady II. Sanaya Lavon Toddy. Cheyenne Alexis Marlowe. Amara Diane Elaine Lander. Anaya Janae Torrey. Storm Delante Marquise White Atkins. Marquand Kumari Douglas. Zion Alexis Jackson. Ryan Lamar Rogers. Joe Lewis Eccles III. Kanisha Kanila Adams. Nathan Thomas Doucette. Anatoly Endozeye.
David Gray Dennis. Noah Ramon Oglesby. Mark Brewer. Omer Bashir Saeed. Miracle Shirlise Ann Shelton. Dayon Marquise Mills. William Aaron Daniels. Jamel James Brown. Darius Ballard. Tyrone Leon Nichols Jr. Tori Easter. Torian Quentin Allen. Chantel Leanne King. Imani Minier Evans. Azoria Denise Littlejohn. Nicole Owino Owino. Ebondo Annie Capapula. Jamia A Blessing Thompson. Carrion Antonio Boykin. Brianna Nicole Watts. Jaden Lene Montgomery. Amari Danae Copeland. Rajane Dezan Terrence. Natalie Marie Blake. Destiny Faith Brandenburg. Evelyn Hernandez. Zakayla Jandrea Lynn Bates. Micah Simone Johnson. Lakaya Dominique Woodard. Nathaniel Lee Bailey. Ania Mercedes Harris. Deabria Niashe Benson. Cheyenne Marie Bell. Michaela Maylin Kyrie Yvonne Hampton. Leanne Alicia Thompson. Ashari Zamar Crum. Jada Nicole Thomas. Jalia Michelle Stollings. Cheyenne Sante Smith. Heaven Daylin Green. Brooklyn Jada Hardy. Lakayla Janae Rivers. Carlay Desiree Darden. Aaron Jordan Stinson. Pascal Urankunda. Keyshawn Hill. Ethan Michael Koo. Allison Marie Shavers. Melvin Melendez Espinoza. Axel Steven Jimenez Quiros. Michael Giovanni Cerdes Avila. Tavi Demetrius Gifford. Emmanuel Nathan Houston. Leon Mahone. Xander David Peters. DeAndre Lemaire Mitchell. Raul Abraham Robledo Montalvo. Rodria Unique Smith. Shavante Eugene McGriff. Genesia Clarissa Thomas. Ryan Ajane Bernard. Jerea Lynn Patrick. Toby Black. Sumi Kofi. Jalen Nicole Tall. Ashari Nicole Carr. Devin Trayshawn Hobson. Kevin Eric Johnson III.
Imagine.
Darmar Darnell George. Jakeem Henry Jr. Jayshawn Malik Israel. Robert Ray Gates III. Futon Pierre Respris. Zachary Sebastian Mons. Kyle Anthony Lowen. Jacob Francis Richard Abels. Alexis Jane Fitter. Emily Marie Reisner. Zachariah Majesty Jervis. Jeannie Ann Walton. Dondrell Quavion Finley. Peyton Phoenix Lyons. Omar Isaiah Daniels. Robert Joseph Robinson. Zarian Lee Weaver. Dayon Bailey. Kayon Maurice Harris. Please welcome to the stage Imaria Combs for the turning of the tassels.
To express how proud I am of each and every last one of my fellow classmates for being able to get through one of the toughest times in our lives. Last year, I know graduating felt impossible to accomplish. COVID truly did take away a lot that we look forward to, but we were still able to overcome the obstacles, and here we are today, Saturday, Saturday, June 26, 2021, as Ponitz Career Technology Center graduates. After today, I know many of us will part ways and go to school or in our careers, but we will always be a family. From day one, August 15, 2017, we have always been very close. We helped each other with homework. We've tutored each other, but more importantly, we became one. From cheering on our ninth grade classmates as they won the city championship, to consoling one another as many of us have lost someone very close to our heart who we feel should be here today. I want everyone to know that that someone is here watching over all of us and is so proud of you. I truly pray that after today, everyone goes off and accomplishes every goal that they have set for themselves, and that they continue to make their families proud. We are officially signing out and logging off. But lastly, I want to thank all of our teachers, administrators, counselors, and staff members for being there for us every step of the way. We truly could not have done this without you. The turn of the tassel from the right to the left symbolizes your movement from a high school student to a high school graduate. Classmates, please join me in turning your tassel from the right to the left. As each of you, as you celebrate. celebrates the next chapter in your life. Please welcome to the stage Alea Young. Thank you.
Either way, it's fine. I'll take the clip though, so today doesn't lose her spot. There you go. That's why there's clips. Okay. If your hat goes, I got it.
Can y'all hear me? Good evening, Panthers and Panther families. I am standing here today to reflect upon these 4 years we have spent in high school. When we came to Ponitz in 2017, never did anyone think that we would be graduating in the middle of a pandemic. We would have never thought that we would be wearing masks everywhere that we went. And it didn't cross our minds that we will be graduating in the middle. No, that's not the one. And it didn't cross our minds that we will be completing the most important year of high school on a computer. To be a part of it is such a blessing and a curse. Yes, of course, we had to make many changes within our lives, both academically and personally. But being in the midst of all of this has forced us to slow down and listen to what the universe has been trying to tell us. Everything doesn't have to be perfect all the time. Everything doesn't have to be rushed, but valued and appreciated. At the beginning of the school year, we had zero faith that we would all make it work and that it would all work out fine. I mean, zero. But standing here today in front of all of my peers has proven to us and everyone else that anything is possible as long as you keep going and never give up. I would like to thank all of my friends and family members that have kept me going over the years and helped to make me the young woman that I am today. They know who they are. And I would like to thank all of the Ponitz families that are in the stands today, as they have helped their children accomplish just as much as I have. Being a small part of it is really one of the greatest things I could ever ask for. My name is Alea Young, and without further ado, congratulations, class of 2021! Woo! Yeah! Please welcome my fellow former classmate, Rajanae Tarrant.
Good evening. My name is Rajanae Tarrant. Before I begin, I would personally like to thank family, friends, staff, and the class of 2021. I would also like to thank my amazing teacher, Ms. Thompson, and my grandmother, Terry. Without the two of them, I probably wouldn't be standing here right now. We finally made it to graduation. We have overcome one of the many major milestones in our young lives. In middle school, my teachers always stressed to me about how stressful high school was going to be and how I should expect the unexpected. Nothing they told me could have prepared me for this, though. High school was one of the most stressful and frustrating things I've ever experienced in my life. There were times where I wanted to pull my hair out, cry, and go in the corner and say and forget it. COVID obviously didn't make the situation any better. With schools and businesses shutting down, it really impacted and affected our opportunities for learning. I honestly thought I wouldn't make it here because of all the instructional time we lost, but here we are. High school wasn't completely terrible. It helped me pave the way to my future. I met some amazing people that have helped me out tremendously and made a large impact on my life. Had some great laughs and experience with my classmates, and it has also molded me into the mature young adult I am today. Graduation marks the end of another extraordinary chapter in our lives. With this chapter ended, we now have to finish writing our own books for ourselves. Most of our lives, it has been our parents and guardians writing for us. Now it's our turn. Even though we made it here, this is not the end. It's only the beginning of our adult lives and the journey of life. No matter where your journey takes you, you will always have this experience to look back on as a lesson. These last 4 years should serve as a launching point, sending us to where our lives see fit. Now is our time to shine and reach for the stars and take hold of our destiny and shape them to our liking. Here's one of my fellow classmates who is doing just that, Kerryon Boykin.
Good evening. Good evening to the superintendent and all Dayton Public School dignitaries, David H. Ponitz administration, teachers, and everybody else in attendance today. March 9th, 2020 was the day when all of our lives took a slight turn for the worse. That was the day COVID hit Ohio, causing things to shut down, including school. Plus, we was trying to rebuild from the tornadoes that hit and damaged some of our homes Memorial Day weekend in 2019. Regular schooling for us ended on March 13, 2020, which we would never anticipate. Adapting to virtual school wasn't as easy as it seemed. Many of us showed up when we wanted to, and many of us just gave up in general. Teachers just constantly asking us to turn on our cameras to make sure that we were in attendance, the numerous amounts of emails that were being sent out to us from our instructors, the constant flow of Google Classroom assignments, which seemed like they would never end. Man, those months were so stressful on us. But like the fathers we are, we finished out our junior year praying that our senior year will go back to normal. Well, we was wrong about that one. We all found out that we were more than likely going to be virtual for the first 9 weeks of school. Everybody's motivation to finish school just went out the window. Come back. There we go. After the 9 weeks were up, most of us were happy. After the 9 weeks were up, most of us was happy to get back to school just so we wouldn't be in our parents' faces 24/7. Everything was cool until we had our first case of COVID, which made us go back out virtual again. But we anticipated and waited for us to be let back into the building. Once we got back, we had to leave once again for Thanksgiving break, which turned into winter break, which turned into freedom for us, really. Many of us had gotten jobs and weren't really worried about school any longer. Then school started back up and most of us were just mentally over it, either because we didn't want to condition our minds to start traditional school again or had jobs that we needed to help support ourselves and our families. There was no way that the two schedules were going to be able to work together. We didn't do a homecoming dance or a traditional sports season, but we still managed to go out with a bang in athletics. You know, beat Dunbar for the first time in 12 years. Shout out to my, You know, then prom season came around and everything was still borderline, but guess what? Ponitz pulled it off. And me personally, I had a ball, you know. We all do. Basically. Can't nobody say that you didn't finish high school or you never got your high school diploma, because you did. No matter how much we wanted to give up, no matter how much we hated wearing our mask, no matter how much our teachers got on our nerves, no matter how many robocalls we received about changes occurring in the building, we stuck through it and all proved the naysayers wrong. Victory is ours. Yeah. We are somebody, and we will do big things with our lives. We will not be anybody's statistic or failure, but instead, we will be somebody's doctor, nurse, dentist, dental hygienist, accountant, bank specialist, someone's mechanic, architect, graphic designer, future famous media person, someone's future hairstylist or makeup artist, someone's future famous fashion designer, future contractors for buildings or homes, somebody's chef, radio or television host, future biotechnicians and IT technicians. We all have been trained to be somebody in society. We will be great in life no matter how hard life gets. I say this to say congratulations to the class of 2021. We did it and we out.
Please rise. Congratulations, class of 2021. Parents, we will meet you on the other side.
The good life, so keep it coming with the bottles, so she feel booze like she bombed out of Apollo. The good life, it feel like Houston, it feel like Philly, it feel like DC, it feel like VA or the Bay or yay. Hey, this is the good life. Homie, tell me what's good. Why I only got a problem when you in the hood?
Welcome to the good life.
Like I'm doing the hood. The only thing I wish
it. Welcome to the good life.
But I don't think he should.
Welcome to the good life.
50 told me, go ahead, switch the style up. And if they hate, then let them hate and watch the money pile up. The good life.
I come from mine.
Yeah,
I got to shine.
Now throw your hands up in the sky.
I come from mine.
I got to shine.
Now throw your hands up in the sky. I'ma get on this TV, mama. I'ma
Hey, 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 yeah. Hey, hey.
Have you ever popped champagne on a plane while getting some? She said I know. snakes on a plane. Whether you broke or rich, you gotta get this. Having money's not everything, that having it is. I was splurging on trips, but when I get my car back activated, I'm back to Vegas, cause I always had a passion for flashing before I had.